can you cut trim and buy shorter pieces of it at Lowe's and Home Depot? People see these cut stations around and they get the impression that you can use them to shorten any piece of trim that you like. But that's not quite how it works. This is the first part of a series I'm calling Don't Get Embarrassed at the Lumberyard. I'm breaking down how things work at home improvement stores in the hopes that it helps you navigate them more confidently. So today I'm going to explain when you can and can't cut trim for purchase. And that's coming up next on The Honest Carpenter Show. Okay, so the trim aisle is usually near the framing and sheet lumber somewhere, and it has all these long sticks of lumber standing vertically in stalls. These are the trim and moldings we use to beautify and hide the edges and corners of our homes. It seems straightforward. You purchase the stuff, take it home, and install it however you like. But the problem is that a lot of these pieces are 12 to 16 feet long. You might not need that much trim, and furthermore, you might not be able to transport anything that long. This is where the cut stations come in, and they frequently cause confusion. Because at times, you'll see dozens of smaller cutoff pieces in or around the station. And you might even see someone with a 5 to 6 foot piece of trim on the way to the registers. So, what's the deal? Can you really purchase trim pieces in these smaller sizes? The answer is yes, sometimes. In most of the big box stores and even some mom and pop lumber yards, trim lumber typically comes in two designations, sold by piece or sold by linear foot. You'll usually see this denoted somewhere on the product display. It may be a little LF to indicate linear foot. This means that that particular piece of trim in that bay can be purchased by the linear foot. So you can take that longer piece to the cut station, measure out your desired length, and cut it off. Then you can just pay for that section. There are, of course, some limitations to this. Some stores have length minimums, like 3 to 4 feet. But in those cases, you are allowed to get just that much. On the other hand, if the trim tag or display doesn't indicate a linear foot system, then that means it's probably sold by the whole piece. This is often indicated by a little EA beneath the price. This stands for each. You cannot break this piece down and expect to pay less. You have to buy the whole stick. You can still take it to the cut station and cut it down some if it's going to help you transport it home, but you're still on the hook for buying the whole piece of trim. With linear foot moldings though, you can sort of dice them up to whatever sizes you want. Just be sure to take a piece with a product sticker on it to the registers so they can ring you up for it more easily. There are a lot of different types of trim in the store. Also, if you have a long section of cut-off lumber left over, take it and put it back with the rest of its kind. This keeps things tidy and organized, and the next person who comes along may just need an 8-foot stick, and it's standing right there waiting for them. Likewise, if you're only browsing for a smaller piece of trim, before you buy a full piece, look in the LF section for the trim profile you need. Shuffle things around a bit. You might just find a shorter stick that'll fit your purposes. And if you need something really short, try looking in the cut station bins too. You'll be amazed at the cutoff varieties that you'll find in certain stores. In some instances, a worker may even mark it as free or for pennies on the dollar if you're nice to them and they're just trying to get rid of stuff. If you do need to cut something, do it carefully. Here are a few quick tips. Most of these stations have a short, fine finish saw on hand. Push your piece all the way down on the cut table and press it against the stop at the back. Set the saw wherever you want to cut and make very gentle, small back and forth strokes until the blade teeth are notched in. At this point, you can increase your stroke distance a little, but don't go overboard. Fine-tooth saws are made for short, controlled strokes. Just let the teeth do the cutting. It's supposed to take a while. Anyways, that's how trim cut stations work at the big box stores. I hope that helps and that it saves you from some confusion. Let me know what you think down in the comments. I'll link a few helpful trim tools in the description. Feel free to shop those links if you need something. As always, thanks for watching. Be sure to check back in for more videos coming up soon. And please consider subscribing and hit that little bell button to turn on notifications. That way you'll know the moment we post something. I'm Ethan James with TheHonestCarpenter.com. I'll see you next time.